social.
Until I was 40, I found an advice. I lived in upstate New York, and every.
Well, but I guess the advice I would give is honestly work with what you have. When I started, I didn't have like an expensive camera. I didn't have backdrops. I didn't have anything. I literally just started recording videos on my phone, and I was white, so I literally just did like I literally just started doing videos like on YouTube and. Honestly, I wasn't really growing as much. What I started doing was looks on Instagram. Like, I would literally serve looks. Like, I would just come up with something, do it, and it just started blowing up on Instagram. So my best advice to get in this industry, it really depends on what you want to do, because I also really pick up on clients, which is something that right now I'm not doing as much as I used to. But it really depends if you want to be a makeup artist, like a freelance makeup artist, or a beauty influencer. But my thing is I like to mix both of them.
Me too. So,
there'll be days where it's like, why am I doing this? With anything in life, once again. And I think with both of those, once you overcome them, consistency and patience, you will get to wherever you want to go. And I always look back now and I'm like, I've been doing this for like almost 2 years now. And I'm like, how did I have the patience at the beginning to just post pictures of myself? Everyone probably thought like, who is this girl think she is? Like, does she really think she's like that cute to like post these pictures and stuff, you know? I don't know what I was thinking, but I did it, and I think about it now, and I'm like, wow, like I'm proud of myself, the person that I used to be as well as I am now. So once again, consistency is number one, I think, for this industry and pretty much anything you're gonna do in life.
Thank you.
So my tips would definitely putting out what people want to see, but things that you enjoy putting out. Because if you're doing things that don't make you happy, what's the point? Like, it becomes a job. And I think for me, social media is a career, but it's not a job. It doesn't have to be, I don't want to do this today. Like, I don't feel like posting today. I don't feel like doing my makeup, because it does become that if you force yourself to do things you don't want to do. So I think if you just keep being yourself and you keep doing what you want to do your own style, do the eyeliner however you want to do it. You know what, if people are leaving you comments like, that's messed up, just keep doing it. Keep doing what you enjoy doing. It doesn't matter what other people tell you to do, as long as you're consistent within yourself.
Well, I started out a year ago and I got real excited when I got 100 views. I was like beside myself. Today it's going, it's almost 17,000 views, so I'm excited.
17 million?
Million.
17 million views, guys.
17 million views.
Oh my god. I didn't even know that. I thought it was 17,000. Oh my god, 17 million views. So, you know, for me it's really new to be out in front of everybody, but I need you guys to know that you're good enough. You're good enough, whether you're a female, a male, it doesn't matter. If you have something that you don't like, change it. Nobody can change it for you, and you have to change it up here. If you don't change it in your brain, you don't change it anywhere. So that's my tip for you guys, is that look at yourself honestly and say, I can live with this, but what can I do to make it better? And you'll notice your life will get better, you'll be happier, and you know, you can get 17,000 million, whatever it is.
Thank you, Jen. And like also say, beauty is more than just skin deep, you know? It goes within yourself, and that's what we try to bring here in the Miami Make Special, aside from this amazing products that you can get here, but bringing this kind of influential to kind of get you guys that influence, I guess you would say, to be able to reach your goals if you want to be a makeup artist, an influencer, a beauty influencer as well. Now I will open up the mic to anybody that has questions to any of these panelists. Any questions you may have in regards to equipment, anything that you have in your mind that you want to ask them before we go to the meet-and-greet? No? Great. You guys, you have anything else you want to say to the crowd? Any final tips before we head to the meet-and-greet?
Thank you for standing in front of us. I really appreciate it. So thank you guys for waiting and even coming here. It's amazing.
All right, guys. Yeah, we want to thank you so much for coming. I know it's been a rough couple of months for us with the hurricane coming through. I know everybody has gone through some tough times here in Miami. But thank you again for coming. And we'll be staying here. Make your line, please. If you don't make your line, you want to take a picture with them for us, and make your line this way, you'll come up here and take a picture with them. Okay? So, thank you so much.
Come back next year.